Sir, question number 143.
Minister,
your statement is laid on the table of the House.
Supplementary, please.
Thank you, Speaker, sir. Sir, I would like to thank our beloved Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji for his ambitious smart city mission. Sir, in 7 cities of Karnataka, namely Belagavi, Bengaluru, Davanagere, Hubli Dharwad, Mangalore and Shivamogga and Tumkuru, we are seeing unprecedented developmental activities, sir. Around 817 projects worth 17,160 crore have been taken up. These projects will certainly change the fate of these 7 cities, sir. Sir, but unfortunately, when this smart city mission was announced in 2015, June 25th, my city, Mysuru, name did not figure in the shortlisted cities, sir. I am not blaming anyone else, but we'll have to blame ourselves because we were unable to utilize 80% of the money we got under JNRM. And Mysuru City Corporation did not do the local auditing from 2011. So the Karnataka government was unable to recommend the name of Mysuru, sir. But, sir, as far as the cities which have got less than 1 million population is concerned, in Swachh Bharat Sarvekshan, we are number one, we are the cleanest city in India, sir. But unfortunately, we did not, you know, get the developmental funds under smart city project, sir. I just like to ask our honorable minister, is there a proposal before the government to extend the list of smart cities, or whether they are going to come up with the second list of smart cities, sir? Thank you.
Sabhapati Mahoday, I fully empathize with the sentiment just expressed by my distinguished colleague and honorable member from Mysuru. The smart city program is a unique program that has been implemented in the country for the first time. It was conceived as soon as the Modi government took office in May 2014, and it was announced in June 2015. The idea was to use technology in order to introduce ease of living and inclusive and sustainable development. So the process of selecting the 100 smart cities was not a selection process ordained by the central government. In fact, a system of competitive bidding was announced, and all cities that wished to compete for inclusion in the smart cities project were invited to submit specific proposals which they would implement over a 5-year period. Now, the center's contribution to this is about 48,000 crore. The overall smart city project is worth 200,000 and 5,000 crores. The center gives 500 crores per year to each of the selected smart cities. The honorable member mentioned that the smart cities selected in Karnataka have done exceptionally well. Out of the total amount released, 1,721 crores, the smart cities of Karnataka have already utilized 1,563 crores, which represents 91% of the amount allocated. The honorable member said that these projects will change the fate, the shape and of these 7 smart cities. I agree with that, and the evidence of that is already available. Honorable Speaker, when I was included in the Council of Ministers in 2017, in September, I used to be asked, where are the smart cities? I took some pains to find out, to tell people that, look, the smart city project is a unique project. It takes about a year or two to set up a special purpose vehicle and to set up a project management consultant. Today, we are seeing the results. Insofar as the inclusion of Mysuru, he's absolutely right, the honorable member, Mysuru was not included. not because the central government was not wanting to include Mysuru, but it was a system of seeking an election, putting forward proposals. And I said, the central government gives to each of these smart cities a total amount of 500 crores over 5 years, which is 100 crores. I think I misspoke when I was earlier. What do we do now? Clearly, it is our expectation that the 7 smart cities of Karnataka or the 10 smart cities of Uttar Pradesh, or for that matter, all the other smart cities, these are all being ranked against the performance that they are registering each other. Now that is having a lighthouse effect. When other cities see the kind of progress that these smart cities are registering, they are wanting their own cities to be included. Now, will there be a follow-up to the 100 smart cities, Honorable Speaker? That is something we will need to say. It is also our expectation that with the progress registered, other cities may wish to look at the experience gained, the best practices which these smart cities have shown, and maybe apply those autonomously. Thank you very much, sir.
Supplementary.
Chairman, sir, I am thankful to our Honorable Minister Hardeep Puri ji, and he can understand our problem, sir. He knows Mysuru. Sir, whenever we visit a city, what is the first thing we get to see? That is cleanliness, sir. To clean up the city, we need to have legacy waste plant. We need to have a C&D plant. For that, we need money, sir. At least our Honorable Minister, if he is kind enough to give money under Amrut project for these projects, I will be more than happy, sir. Thank you.
Sir, as I started my response to the first supplementary, I fully empathize with the sentiment expressed by the Honorable Member. I also have a very deep relationship with the state of Karnataka, sir, a personal relationship. But under Amrut or any other scheme, the center stands ready to cooperate. But the state annual action plans are drawn up by the state government. They can reposition. But insofar as sewage treatment, insofar as septic treatment is concerned, there will be a follow-up to the Amrut scheme. In fact, the Honorable Finance Minister in her budget statement for 2021-22, in fact, specifically mentioned a Swachh Bharat Mission Phase 2 and an Amrut follow-up. The Amrut scheme, sir, only covers 60% plus of India's urban population, and the government is actively considering a follow-up scheme which will cover 100% of the urban area, sir.